trip we had, eh?
I know.
It was 10 days from. It was crazy. Yeah, we got to the airport and my parents were there.
It was so good to see your parents after all that time.
2.5 years.
Yeah, it was great.
And what was your first memory after that?
Ooh, whirlwind exploration of Westmount and off to the museum. That's.
Well, why did we go to the museum, Lisa?
To see the Christmas trees.
So this is the baby's room, and we're just fixing it up, aren't we, Lisa?
Yes, baby Richardson is getting...
And what do we have here?
We have Cece,
our real baby,
yes. He's very excited about the new arrival, mm-hmm. Aren't you, Cece?
Can't wait. And who else do we have?
Crying.
Who else, Lisa, do we have in here?
Here's Benny.
Where did Benny come from?
This is from Jane. Jane gave us Benny.
He's warming the bed up.
He's warming up the bed for
and
baby.
Who, and who's Benny's friends here? Benny has some friends.
Hunka Munka and Mrs. Mack.
Mrs. Mack. Oh, that's
found
right.
Soulmates.
She's out here for the birth, I understand. She's there's a bit of a separation happening. Oh, I better not talk about that.
No, we don't need to talk about it right now.
So anyway, you know what else we did? I guess you do, because you were there. But we went and saw my dad curl.
Yes,
down
we did.
In that, forget the name of the building now. No, the research has been terrible on this. But it was had three rinks, and we watched my dad curl, and you actually talked to my dad about what it was like and what curling meant to him.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. not a lot for me. I didn't start till I retired. And getting through the long winter here, it's been a great success for me, and socially. And it gives me, you know, 2 hours of exercise 2 or 3 times a week.
Is there a comradeship?
A lot of good fellowship. Yeah, it's a very nice group of people. I go to Toronto to play in the over 70s, they call it the Masters. Toronto Cricket Club started 5 years ago.
It was always the Montreal Curling Club from 1807 until 1924. And 1924 we got the right from the king to add the title royal to the club.
Down here we have the minutes of the first meeting of the curling club in 1807 on the 22nd of January, including the organization for the meal afterwards. They always, and we still on our Saturday lunches have exactly the same menu as they had, with salt beef and greens. This is a telegram that was received by the ladies' branch from King Edward VII in 1807. It reads, "News has just reached London of your great victory. The king offers his congratulations." This was my father's granddaddy when he curled. Balmoral, I'm sorry, it's a Balmoral, and I wear it for curling. These are some of the pins from the clubs we played at, including our own, and some of these are club competitions that I won in my early days
in the Chicken League.
Well, nearly all the new members curl in that every Monday night.
Does it bring you luck?
Well, you hope so.
Here we are in our new study.
Oh, what's going on here, Lisa?
Well, I'm sending a fax actually to your office.
Oh, that's pretty high tech. Oh, it's working.
Well, this is the Richardson's home.
That's ringing. So anyway, listen, while we were in Montreal, what was your most favorite time, or one of your most favorite times?
Oh, probably going to the Velodrome with your dad. That was a lot of fun, especially when the audio didn't work in the end and we had to go back. That was a...
Thank you, Lisa.
You're welcome, John. Let's go to that segment now.
Close though. want to know how you liked it. Did you have a good time?
Yes, we did. I did.
It's great. I don't know why more people don't come and see it.
What's your favorite part, Dad?
Well, I think I like the rainforest.
Yeah.
It's so different. The rest of it, we know something about.
Yeah. What about you, Lisa?
I liked the golden monkeys.
Yeah.
And the lynx. We saw lynx this time.
Oh, you did, eh?
Yeah.
Oh, good.
It reminded me very much of Cece.
Yeah.
Licking his fur.
Okay, thanks.
Bye.
See you next time.
Okay.
So what are you going to wear tonight?
Well, I don't know. Let's see. This is yours.
Yeah, you've got so many clothes, Lisa, in there.
I know.
They hold so many memories. What? Talk to me. Tell me what. Where's this from?
This is from Value Village.
Oh.
This was my big $5 bargain buy.
And
everybody loves it. They always say, wow, where did you get that shirt? Well, it's my $5 Value Village bargain buy.
Everybody who knows, even people who didn't really care. But anyway, listen, you know, clothes are memories. What, you know, and speaking of memories, we went on a very memorable trip on, was it Christmas Eve?
Christmas Eve day.
Yeah, we went to Magog.
Man for Magog.
Yeah.
Helen and her family's summer, I guess.
Yeah, it holds
place.
A lot of memories for my mother.
Yeah, it was beautiful. Yeah. Beautiful day,
had
beautiful
some,
memories.
Some tea and chocolate chip cookies.
Yes, inside the kitchen with Mr.
We don't remember his name, but he was a nice guy.
Gosh.
That's it.
Oh, it was his name.
That's like, we're going to edit out of that by then.
No, we got it.
Lisa, I want to show you where we're going today. This is an old scrapbook that I must put together again. I've taken a lot of pictures out over the years. So we're going to start here to show you our cottage where I grew up and where John came every summer of his life. And as the time went along, I don't know if John remembers that this was the little changing house where we took out into our bathing suits, but I think that was probably, it stayed there a long time, but I never used it. I used to just run down from the house.
This
is Lake Memphremagog. That is an Indian word, which means beautiful waters. And later on, Alec took a picture of it when the films were of color, which gives the same idea in a way.
Now, is this from a different location?
Yes,
this is the front?
This is from the back here.
Okay.
Over here,
here.
Alec's taking a picture from over here. There was a nice lawn here in front with a garden. And then there was a huge hedge like this, so we were very private from the water. This is also the cottage here in a long, long ago. And this is my great uncle, Frank Scaife, that owned the house.
Originally,
it was his home. It was the only home he ever had. He traveled all the time. He was married, he didn't have any children, and he was very good to me.
Wow.
So I'm about 8 there. Now, I don't know, go across around here. This is on the gallery. These are my friends that, well, Anne, Peachy Whitehead, that lives in Brockville, yeah. Elaine Markham, who's the mother of the child in Greece, and Elsie Mitchell. And there we are at the end of the dock with Anne and her best friend, Babs Drum, and Uncle Frank with our dog, Michael. Now, I don't know if I've got any. Yes. These are yours truly diving.
Mm. Oh, they're great pictures.
Thank you. And this is a little,
wow.
This is a, they did an article on the Hermitage Club in the 1938. So this is the club as it is, as it was then, but now when we go today, this is all glassed in.
Look at this, you're in it.
Yes, I'm in it.
Diving tries a new one.
Helen tries a new one, and Elsie looks on from the water. This is one of the greens on the golf course, and this is a little scene from the lake nearby. One of the people that owned a cottage there, Mrs. Eldon Wilson, had a big party, and the person that was doing the article came and took a picture of the group. I don't think there's anything more about the Hermitage here. I think we're kind of at the end of it. I've just stuck it in. So that's what
we're going to
our adventure will take us there today. This is Christmas evening, December 24th, 1994. A special weekend, as Lisa and John are with us from Vancouver for the first time since their marriage. We are trying to fit into this visit as many places as possible,
Therefore, when Lisa suggested a drive, we have chosen to go down into the townships and head for Magog, a place of memories over so many summers past. Going back in time, our family first came here around 1860, where Adam Scaife rented a farmhouse and brought his family of four, which included my grandmother Roland. Later, she owned the property with her 10 children, and they all came by train and brought trunks. When I came, I also came by train, arriving around 10 at night, and the excitement of hearing the conductor calling out, "Magog, Magog." Arthur Lange, the taxi man, met us, and soon we were rolling along the Georgeville Road and then dipping down into the Hermitage Club grounds, where our cottage was one of 32 which surrounded the clubhouse, which was the center of this enclave. But six had their own dock on the edge of Lake Memphremagog, an Indian word which means beautiful waters. The lake is 32 miles long. Where we were situated, you could swim across to the other side to the little white lighthouse, which was 3/4 to 1 mile. Many of us did this. Our pleasures were simple. We rode our bicycles around the club roads and into Magog on the dirt roads. We could use the tennis courts, and all the young were encouraged to play golf. So history repeated itself when Anne, Jane, and John grew up here with my mother. Magog will always be close to my heart. When you have spent some 50 years in one place and sit on the dock and look across to Mount Orford and see Owl's Head a little further down the lake, the memories return. We climbed these mountains and picnicked at the top, as my father had done. So today, Lisa will see where John and his sisters spent their growing up years in July. Welcome, Lisa.
So this is our wonderful fridge full of memories. We've just come from the memories of Magog, and now we're memories of Lisa and John and all their friends. And there's Carrie. Carrie's doing camera right now. But anyway, you know, being in the kitchen reminds me of being at Jane and Dennis's for Christmas dinner on Christmas Day.
Wonderful turkey dinner.
Yeah. And even though there was a little bit of the turkey at the very top that was wrecked, so the picture I have's got a scar on it. But other than that, it was a nice time. And it was just amazing how silly people can get when they're with family at Christmas time. Don't you agree?
You mean sillier than this?
No.
To John! Merry Christmas, John! Thank you very much! It was the night before Christmas, and all through the night, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. Jane!
The stockings were hung by the chimney with hair, and all from St. Nicholas soon to be there. Karen.
Oh, thank you.
The children.
The children.
We're nestled.
All stuck in their beds.
Visions.
Shortage bumps. That's in their heads.
Visions.
Sugar bumps.
That's in their heads.
What do you want me to do?
Okay.
Now you can read the next verse.
Okay. Jane.
Different.
Shop.
Where am I?
And.
Mama.
Oh, no. Hey, cheating!
Well, what do you want me to do?
Mama!
Oh, I got.
Sorry, and Mama in her kerchief.
And I
in my cap.
Had settled down.
Had just settled our brains for a long winter's nap.
Okay, shall?
No, you don't need the boy.
Wait.
Yeah. Out on the lawn, there arose such a clatter. I sprang out of bed to see what was the matter.
That's right.
Allison.
Allison.
Out on the lawn, there arose such a clatter. I sprang from my bed to see
what was the matter.
I sprang from my bed.
I flew like a flash.
Can you see it?
I opened the shutters and threw up the sash.
I think it was a flasher. You didn't read the part.
Who's next?
Don't worry about it. It's okay.
Okay, Mother.
I can wait.
No.
The moon on the crest.
What
crest.
Is it?
Oh, new fallen snow.
Yeah. Gave the lust.
It what?
Gave the luster.
Luster.
Fifth day.
Okay. Oh, below. Vomit below.
And the orange glow.
What's it? Is that it?
No. To objects below. When what to my wondering eye should appear? But a miniature sleigh.
With eight tiny reindeer.
And Rudolph came later.
A little old driver. Don't eat any of my knowledges.
On Dasher, on Blitzen, on...
Where's so lively and quick.
It's a lovely book here.
And I knew in a moment it must be safe.
Okay, hang on, let me see the... Okay, here we go.
There's the bird.
Hang on. No, you're the bird.
Okay.
I'm bird. In case.
And there's the catcher.
The
fail-safe mechanism.
The insurance is there.
Wait, get the brown paper. Okay.
Oh, it's all right.
Can we do it again?
Now, can you hold it, Jane?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yeah, wait a minute. No.
Okay.
It's okay.
The bird has been transported. Whoa.
Oh. It's gliding.
Whoa!
Any words of...
Nearly transported itself. Any blessings?
The bird nearly flew off. Now, it's unusual for a turkey to fly off with all this stuffing.
Can you keep this to 30 seconds? That's all I want.
Oh, this is really nice, and soot on the potatoes. It wasn't much room in the stove.
Plain soot.
That's okay. It's a country turkey.
That's just a little bit.
Probably that. I have to test them. They're hot enough.
Good British Navy rum always helps to drink, to get a pump pudding.
One more time. Want to do it again?
Rhymes. Good British Navy rum always helps to get a plum pudding drunk. And me too. So we're gonna do it. Well, I won't get lit up. Oh, wow. There we go. Now, if this doesn't light up, I won't eat it.
Okay, hurry up.
Turn off the lights.
Okay, hurry up. Hey, everyone, look at face.
Little Christmas carol.
Do you want to carve it up?
Okay, no, you're going to parade it right back in there now.
Oh, oh, I'm going to light it up.
I won't light it up again because now it's all saturated.
Okay, now
I
got the calipers on. John.
Yes.
Sorry.
What happened with this?
We didn't let it burn too long because that destroys the alcohol content of the plum pudding. So now we have the full value of the British Navy rum, which will be transported into everybody's stomach.
Come on.
Jeez. Come on.
You remember when we were up at Brackenhill?
You mean the perfect little paradise?
That little perfect paradise.
On Lake Brulé.
And we went for a walk, and Dennis told us all those wonderful things about... Oh, geez, that was a good time, wasn't it? Isn't it time for dinner?
No! I give up.
C'est mon chemin raconte, des filles qui pleurent, je suis pas capable. C'est la montagne qui douche, je suis pas capable. C'est la montagne qui douche, je suis pas capable d'y arriver.
C'est la montagne qui douche, je suis pas capable. C'est la montagne qui douche, je suis pas capable. C'est la montagne qui douche, je suis pas capable d'y arriver.
Je lui ai demandé qu'avez-vous à pleurer.
Je lui ai demandé qu'avez-vous à pleurer.
Quand je suis gagné, je vais pas plus m'en trouver, je suis pas capable. C'est la montagne qui douche, je suis pas capable. C'est la montagne qui douche, je suis pas capable d'y arriver.
C'est la montagne qui douche, je suis pas capable. C'est la montagne qui douche, je suis pas capable. C'est la montagne qui douche, je suis pas capable d'y arriver.
But it's not very often.
Why does it happen?
Well, if you get no snow but very cold temperatures for a month, and so, and then if you get a snowfall, it's okay, because what happens to the ice that makes it very impractical is that you'll get snow, then you get a bit of a thaw, and then you'll get cold, and so that the ice is not smooth,
frozen
mush. It's mushy, and then it's a very rugous, it's full of rugae. So it's neat.
And what's really neat is after just a small dusting of snow, you don't realize that it's black ice underneath. So you see your skate just sort of glide through the snow, just about this, you know, on an inch in depth, yeah. Underneath which is this
right.
This black.
And then there's the toboggan run.
That is the most fun. You have to come back when you're not pregnant.
You start and you start
at the living room window.
They come
on a
flying
magic,
down.
Magic carpet, yeah. Piece of plastic sheet,
yeah.
And you come flying out. It really kind of hurts your ribs, but anyway, you kick your legs up and you come right down, down onto the lake. It's really hairy. You scream the whole way down.
Going back up isn't the greatest. So.
Good exercise. That's true, yeah. I don't know what Audie does.
You're scaring them, John.
Here they come.
Oh, we should really get out of bed.
No, I just think, having seen all that footage, I'm exhausted.
Yeah, but we need to go for a walk, like the walks we went with your dad.
Oh, that was pretty challenging.
No, they were great when we went up to the summit.
Yeah? What did you like about those walks the most?
The cold, crisp Montreal weather, and walking with your dad.
And all the old
and
houses.
And the old houses, the old brick houses and stone houses. Yeah. Going up to the top and seeing all of Montreal and Westmount at the top.
It was a good 10 days.
It was a wonderful 10 days.
Yeah. But we're very tired right now. We're going to bed in our new bed that Mother and Dad bought for us. And
thank you.
Thank you. And Margaret bought us this nice comforter. Thank you. Good night.
Bye.
How was your walk today, guys? Did you have a good walk?
We went right up to the top, along the back of Summit Circle. Had a good look at the cemetery.
What was your favorite part? My standard question.
My favorite part of the walk?
Yeah.
The sunshine.
Yeah?
Down
on us. On Christmas Day?
On Christmas Day, 1994, Montreal. You can't beat it.
You were here with your dad? In the winter of 1994, how does it feel?
Those are my same questions. It feels great to be here at Christmas time. It's been a long time. It's always come to Muskoka, so it's nice to be here at Christmas. And bring Lisa with me. She takes us to places we weren't planning to go.
Lisa and friend.
Okay.
Okay, we're going out of the house now.
Okay, here you go. Bye.